Hey guys, Ivan here, and Big Ramy finally posted a photo of himself, a new physique update. It's been a while since he posted anything, and I honestly thought he looked less impressive than this because of that, because he didn't post a lot, but he actually looks pretty damn good. He looks huge, he looks really, really big. And his conditioning right now is basically usual 3 weeks out conditioning. Most bodybuilders are this lean at 2-3 weeks out. But most bodybuilders, when they drop the hammer in those final weeks, they lose so much fat and water and everything, and they look shredded on the day of the show. But Big Ramy, not really the case with him. He has a lot of trouble getting down to those single-digit body fat percent numbers. It's gonna take him longer than 2-3 weeks, and he's 10 weeks out, so it's enough time, definitely enough time, if he's willing to really suffer again, to go to that dark place that he talked about, that Chad Nichols had him go to. So if he does that, at this point, in these 10 weeks, if he really pushes it to the max, he can be shredded, he can be in a good shape. Now, the question is, can he defend the title this year again? Can he do it? That top five last year, a lot of those guys weren't exactly 100% on. So we had William Bonek, who didn't really look like himself. He was smaller than usual and not as conditioned. He was fifth, though. Hadi Chupan was not at his best. His best was Vancouver Pro 2019. Is that the shape that Hadi will never repeat? I don't know, but I do know that last year he wasn't sure if he was going to be able to travel to the US until the final moment. He was training and dieting without even being sure he's going to be competing, so imagine how that feels like. And also, he traveled to the US a couple of days before the Mr. Olympia, so that flight probably took a toll on his body as well. Then you also had Brandon Curry in the second spot. And Brandon was ripped, he was shredded, he was really lean, much leaner than he was when he won the Mr. Olympia. But the price for that conditioning was the leg fullness. He lost a lot of fullness in the legs, and I think that's the only reason why Big Ramy beat him, because he absolutely dwarfed him, especially in the leg department. Other than that, I think everything else was better on Brandon. He had more details, more conditioning, better shape, a lot of good poses. I feel like if he brought better fullness with the improvements that he made in that 1 year, and you know Brandon, he makes improvements every year. If he didn't really go for that crisp conditioning, and he went for that because he thought he was going to be fighting Phil Heath, not Big Ramy. Nobody really saw Big Ramy winning that Mr. Olympia. Very few people did. If he knew he's going to be battling Big Ramy for the first spot, he probably would have went with fullness, because Big Ramy beat him on size. So, if Brandon Curry somehow manages to improve again this year, and I'm sure he will, he always does. That's the thing with Brandon, he always improves, and he's young enough to make those improvements. And if he comes in good condition, better than Big Ramy, that's not very hard to do, and also brings up the legs, come with full legs, he has a legitimate chance of taking Big Ramy down. Same thing with Hadi. If Hadi comes spot on, you know, big, full, and conditioned, he also has a chance. You noticed I skipped Phil Heath because I'm not sure if he is going to be competing. But if he does, we saw those photos, those videos of his stomach. It looks good. It looks fixed. It looks great. So I'm very optimistic that he will do the Mr. Olympia. And if he decides to do it, he has a very good chance of actually winning it. And actually winning a couple of more after that. And probably, you know, winning that ninth title, beating Ronnie Coleman and Lee Hena. I can see that happening for sure. If that's the only problem that he had so far, the gut, and now the problem is gone, it seems, what can stop him? Who can stop him? Big Ramy? I don't think so. Maybe Big Ramy will bring better conditioning this year. Last year, yes, it was good conditioning for him, but come on, guys. Is this really the level of conditioning that we want to be the standard? No. Big Ramy is a great bodybuilder. He's awesome. I was really happy when he won. But this is not the best quality. This is nothing if you compare it to Ronnie Coleman, for example. So bodybuilding right now, it's not very good. Phil Heath, at his best, he annihilates Big Ramy. I mean, Big Ramy never had those kind of details, that kind of conditioning. Not even close, especially in the back. Not even close. So again, there is a lot of guys, the entire top five, actually the other four guys, have a good chance of actually beating Big Ramy. William Bonac, not so much, but he has done that in the past. Though in the past few years, he has not been doing that well. Ever since he parted his ways with his coach, Neil Hill, he hasn't been really doing that well. But Bonac, usually, after the Mr. Olympia, he prepares for Arnold Classic. Arnold Classic was delayed for later this year. So he took an off-season. This is not something William Bonac usually does. Now we're gonna see. Is it gonna make his physique look so much better? If he comes in his, let's say, 2019 Arnold Classic shape, can he beat Big Ramy? And he did beat him at the Arnold Classic 2020. So William Bonac also has a chance of beating Big Ramy this year. And Big Ramy is known for failing with conditioning so many times. Who's to say he's gonna be conditioned this year? I mean, the likelihood is very, very small. The chances are he's gonna be soft. So I wouldn't bet on him, honestly, guys. I mean, yeah, he is the champion, so that kind of gives him some stock. But, like, look at his previous track record. He is not known for bringing the best shape. I mean, he was in shape 2017 and 2020, and that's good shape for Big Ramy. That's not really good conditioning, but let's say those are the years when he brought conditioning. Other years, he was basically always off. That's the thing. So the chance of him being on again are very small. And even if he is on, there are other guys who are better than him when they are on. So that's the top five only. And there is a lot of other up-and-coming guys. We'll see how Ian Valier is going to look like. Akeem Williams, Hunter Labrada, so many other great guys who are right there knocking on that top six door. And I'm not saying they're going to beat Big Ramy or win the Mr. Olympia, but you cannot be sure. Nick Walker, too. Nick Walker is going to be a wild card. We have to see him first at the Arnold Classic, how he fares against the other guys. But if he wins the Arnold Classic, and I can see that happening, that's going to be a huge momentum for him. And we can then discuss him actually taking out Big Ramy or winning the Mr. Olympia even this year. And yeah, he's too young probably to do that. This is going to be his Olympia debut. I believe it never happened before that somebody does the Mr. Olympia for the first time and wins it. Imagine if that happened. And I don't know. I have to see Nick standing next to the other guys. But seeing him stand alone and against the other second, third tier guys, he looks like somebody who can win the Mr. Olympia. Maybe not this year, but one day, who knows. So it's going to be a very, very competitive Mr. Olympia this year. And for Big Ramy to repeat it, he needs to be spot on. And I think he needs to be better than last year. So right now, he does look pretty awesome. He looks his usual self. He's big. He's in good condition for 10 weeks out. We'll see. We'll see what Chad is going to make him do. Is he going to suffer that much and actually get shredded if he does that with all the size that he has? And if he somehow improves the lower back details and also hamstring details, then there is a good chance of him defending the title, but it's not going to be easy. So it's going to be very interesting, Mr. Olympia. I can't wait to see what's going to happen. As for now, you can see what Big Ramy looks like, and he does look very good. Whatever you guys think, can Big Ramy defend the title? How he looks like right now? What do you think? Tell me down below in the comment section. Like this video if you enjoyed it, guys, and please subscribe for more videos like this. All the best, guys, and bye-bye.